A few hours and an outfit change later, and it is time for July. July, I didn't do a whole lot because honestly, it was summer break and I wanted to enjoy summer break. But we had a lot of family movie nights. Most of them were actually themed, which was super duper cool. I remember there was one night where it was just me and Callie in the house, and so we wore princess crowns and watched Barbie Princess Charm School. And that was the highlight of my summer, honestly. At the end of July, I went to Austin, Texas for the very first time for the Greater Austin Suzuki Institute. It was super duper special because I was able to receive my Suzuki Violin Book 1 training from a teacher that I have known for many, many years but never actually had. And so it was really cool to get my teacher training from her. Obviously, I made lots of new friends, and I'm so excited that I was able to meet those people. And one really special thing that happened was I was able to fiddle with one of the members of the faculty and a faculty showcase concert thing, and that was just super duper cool. August, I was in training for the first 2 weeks for my substitute teacher job that I have when I'm back here in Utah. And then on like August 12th, I flew back to Nashville with my dad and we moved in to my dorm for this year. I was able to move in a week earlier than everyone else because I participated in Bold Moves, which was so much fun. I got to meet so many awesome people. I met Abby, Jenna, and Eliza Kate through Bold Moves. So that was extremely fun and satisfying. Meeting new people, obviously. The leadership training that I received was incredible. I mean, that's one of the reasons why I love Bold programming. And on our like day off, we went to Top Golf. Which, side note, I suck at golfing. It is my goal to actually be decent at golfing one day. So if there's anyone out there who would like to teach me how to golf, please let me know. It's just one of those things that I want to learn how to do. I'm really bad at mini golf too. So if someone has the patience to teach me how to golf, it would be very much appreciated, and hit me up. But no, that was so much fun. And then the Saturday, Sunday, and Monday before school started, we moved all of the upperclassmen in. And that taught me how much stronger I am than I seemed. One of my favorite quotes of all time is something Christopher Robin says in Winnie the Pooh, and it says, "Always remember that you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think." And Bold Moves really emphasize the stronger than you seem part. So that was a special moment. Soccer games started, soccer season began like the day that I flew back to Nashville. And so it was really fun to go to soccer games with my friends. I went to almost every single soccer game this season, men and women's. And that is partly because I started working for Belmont Athletics, and that is one of the best decisions I have ever made. Honestly, I love working for Belmont Athletics, and I'm so glad that I had the opportunity to. I met Avery, which is super cool because Avery had communicated in the comments section on my videos for a little bit, and so it was fun to actually put a face to the name and meet in person, and we grabbed lunch and had a great conversation. So hi Avery, that was super fun. On the 25th of August, I attended the SAPB throwback prom, which was 50s theme. This was the very first weekend. And that is a vlog on my channel. That was a memorable moment because I remember a guy was like, "Hey, I like, oh, dang it, they're not playing any music to Cindy out to, and I really want to Cindy up. And I was like, oh my gosh, I want to too. And all my friends seriously thought that was going to be my Hallmark movie meet cute, but I'm here to report that was not my Hallmark movie meet cute. I still have not had that. So anyways, on the 27th is when I put out my video for press play on all platforms. I have never officially released this song, but I had so many people messaging me, telling me how much they related to that song. And that was a really personal song for me to put out. Obviously, because it's talking about some loved ones that have passed on. But a lot of people related to it and thanked me for being able to put those feelings into a song. So you're hearing it here first. I would love to release that song officially in 2024. That song is just super personal, and I do not want to put it out half-hearted. Like Hello Tennessee and You Don't Know may have been. I really want this one to be perfect. And until it is, it will not come out on like Spotify or Apple Music or anything like that. So if you really want to listen to it, I suggest you listen to it on YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, all that sort of stuff, because it's everywhere. We have officially reached September, everybody. September marked the start of BYU football season, and we know how much I love BYU football season. I bought a Chase Roberts jersey, and you can see it in my live reset video because I wore it the entire time. But my roommate would know whenever it was a BYU football day based on whether or not I was wearing said jersey. So thank you for that jersey. I also went to Brew and Boot Camp every single Wednesday, and move in May have helped me see how much stronger it was than I seemed. But Brew and Boot Camp really solidified that, and taught me a lot of, skills that I can't wait to continue to use in my life. On September 6th, the person who is the voice of Larry the Cucumber came and talked to us Belmont students, and that was just a fun speaker, I guess you could say, a fun discussion, and I'm just so glad I was able to go to it. Me, Hannah, and Isabella sat by each other, and we had a blast laughing and listening the entire time. On September 11th, which for all my people living in the United States, September 11th is a day of remembrance. It's sometimes a really sad and somber day, but this year, September 11th was actually a really, really good day for me. I woke up that morning. I made a plan where I had said a few days prior at a soccer game that if a person didn't go up and talk to their crush, I was going to talk to their crush for them. And on September 11th, I woke up that morning and I said, okay, if I see that person at all today, I'm telling them. And lo and behold, I went to grab breakfast in the cafe, which I don't really grab breakfast in the cafe very often. I'm not necessarily a huge breakfast person, much less a cafe breakfast person. So, it was a once in a blue moon opportunity, and I saw that person and I said everything that I had been thinking about. So that happened. And then that day I went to chapel and we had Sister Celeste from Hawaii come and talk. And that was also another special moment because I was sitting on the aisle seat because I knew I would have to like rush out of there and head to my next class. That I was sitting on the aisle seat and she tapped me on my shoulder and she's like, I'm so glad you're here. And she's like, are you Japanese by chance? And I said, yes, I am, which I've never necessarily, had someone been be able to identify my ethnicity right off the bat. And so it was really special for me, and I will forever remember that. I also was able to meet Belmont Betty that day, Miss Betty Wiseman, because she sat in as a guest speaker for my sports leadership class that day. And it was really super special. I was wearing my basketball earrings, and whenever I see her, she's like, "Oh my goodness, how are you?" I'm known as the basketball earring girl, so I feel good about that. So September 11th was a really nice day for me, and I'm pretty sure this is a vlog on my channel, if I remember correctly. I also joined Russell's Community Council, which means that I get to act as a liaison between the RAs and the residents, but I also get to help with setup and decorating for a lot of the events that Russell puts on. So I've loved that. Volleyball season started, and I worked every single game during volleyball season. There was not a single game that I missed. And I was able to get to know a lot of the people who work behind the scenes, which was super duper special. Nowadays, when I see the janitorial and food service staff that I met, they're like, "Oh my goodness, it's so interesting to see you like as an actual student and not during a game." Like, so that was just an awesome experience. I'm so glad I was able to have a part of that. On the 23rd, I put out my very first episode of Spilling Happiness. And I really love that series. In fact, I really want to focus more on that this year and truly make Spilling Happiness a series on all of my platforms. Because I feel like after everything that I went through, especially towards the end of this year, I need to focus on those positive things. And so my goal is to have an episode at least once a week. So you will be getting at least 52 episodes this year on all of my platforms. It would be awesome if I could do one every single day, but I'm not going to hold myself to that because I'm not setting myself up for failure this year. We're setting ourselves up for success. So for those who love Spilling Happiness, you have many more episodes to look forward to this year. To close out September on the 25th, I gave my presentation in my communications class on Lavelle Edwards. I had a wonderful experience researching Lavelle and learning more about him. Obviously, we know how much I love Lavelle Edwards Stadium, and I clearly knew he had a huge impact, but it was really awesome to look at interviews and quotes and see exactly how much of an impact he had on players and fans and coaches. And I gave that presentation, and then a few weeks later I turned in a paper in another class on Lavelle Edwards, and I loved everything that I did for both of those classes. And I would love to give a huge long presentation on Lavelle Edwards in a video format one day, but we'll see if that ends up happening. We have officially reached October, and to start off October, I watched General Conference with Gabby. Once again, we went to Centennial Park, ate some snacks, and I think we watched the Sunday morning session together, if I remember correctly. So that was super special. We have officially decided that this is a new tradition that we are starting, where at least one of the sessions, we will all get together and go to Centennial Park to watch it. So I loved that. October 4th was the Day to Dream, which that is a vlog on the channel if you want to learn more about that. But that was a really fun day. I hadn't really celebrated Day to Dream last year, because I spent that time chilling because it had been a rough semester. So actually partaking in Day to Dream events and festivities was really fun. Me and Julie started watching The Golden Bachelor, and that was so much fun. That ending was not how we wanted it to be, me and Julie, but that's okay. We've officially decided that we have bachelor and bachelorette nights, and we will pop open a bottle of Martinelli's, pull out some little cute wine glasses and whatnot, and drink as we watch. So that was fun. We watched Hannah Brown's bachelorette season because she's one of my favorite bachelorettes ever, and I loved her season, and I just felt like we should just drop Julie into the deep end. So we dropped her into the deep end of bachelorette territory. We will be watching The Bachelor in a few weeks. Joey season. It's going to be great. So we started doing that. October 7th and 8th, I spent those days with Hannah's family. It was so nice to like get to know them better, and we had really fun activities. We went to a corn maze, we took lots of photos, tried new food. I made caramel apples, which we know how much I love caramel apples, everybody. I carved a pumpkin for the first time, so that was exciting. But overall, it was really enjoyable. I got back, and the next day on the 9th, I went to the Jonas Brothers concert at Bridgestone Arena. And oh, okay, I was that girl who was obsessed with Camp Rock, both one and two, as a really little kid. I know every single song word for word. That's how much I watched it. And so I told myself, you know what? We're going to go see the Jonas Brothers. We are going to make our childhood heart happy. And it was everything that I wanted and more. I was singing along the entire night, and I had no voice the next day. So that was fun for me. Thankfully, I didn't have any classes. So it worked out in the end, but I absolutely loved that. And because I loved it so much, that's one of the reasons why I got my mom Paula Abdul and New Kids on the Block tickets, because those were her childhood, and I wanted to make her childhood heart happy as well. So that's one of the reasons. On October 14th, I was wearing my BYU jersey. And I took a mirror selfie, because it was game day, and I tagged those people whose number it is, and one of them actually liked it. So to that person who liked that picture, I want you to know, thank you. You made my day, you made my week, you made my whole month. Not necessarily the whole year, but you definitely made the year very memorable, and I'm so thankful for that. I'm wishing you the best of luck next season. I know you're probably never going to see this, but you never know. I honestly, as soon as I saw that this person liked my photo, I freaked out and sent screenshots to all of my besties and my mom. So, yeah, that was special. A few days later, on the 19th, I had a really interesting experience with a guy. I think I may make that a story time video. But needless to say, we call this guy the Chocolate King Bee, and that experience happened in October. So, love that. November was so much fun. I completed the Proverbs challenge. That Ashley Hetherington put together, and I'm so proud of myself. I accomplished every single day. I didn't necessarily post it on my story every day, but one of the times that I did, Ashley actually reposted it on her story. So that was super special. Basketball pep rally, if I mentioned this already, it did not happen in October. It happened November 2nd. Sorry about that. If I did mention that. But no, I spent that with Kayla and Eliza Kate. We had a blast. November 5th, was a rough day. I had a friendship breakup and I'm still getting over it. But for those of you guys who have messaged me wondering why some people have not necessarily been in photos or stories or videos lately, that's the reason. Obviously, basketball season started. We were one of the very first games to happen for all of the NCAA, and so that was super special. I'm so glad that I was able to go to that game. I worked it, but it was amazing. The environment was top notch. November 9th, I got a care package from my family, and it was just full of awesome notes and goodies and whatnot for my family, and I really needed that at that point in time. It had been a rough few days, since that friendship breakup. And like I said, I'm still reeling from it, so yeah. 2 days later, on November 11th, Pulse happened, which was so awesome. I loved Pulse last year, and I was so excited to go this year. I spent the day with Kayla, Eliza, Kate, Hannah, and Maddie, which me and Maddie had had theory class together in the spring semester, and then we reconnected during Bold Moves, and so spending time with her at Pulse was just really super special, and I enjoyed it thoroughly. Yeah. I can't wait for Pulse next year, because next year I can actually give my tower talk, and then I will be finished with my Bold co-curricular certificate in leadership, which is crazy to think about. I started studying in the library in November, which I can't believe I didn't start studying in the library sooner. I have my special chair where I put in my like AirPods and I just crack out some work. In fact, the majority of my history paper, my blasted history paper, if we're being honest, was written in the library, because that just was the most motivating place for me to be on campus, so I enjoyed that. To close off November, I spent Thanksgiving with Hannah's family, and I'm so glad that they took me under their wing. We stayed at their house until Sunday night, pretty much, so it was like one big sleepover. it was so much fun. It was great to see how other families do Thanksgiving, since I've never really had that before, and I loved that. On the 26th, we went to see The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes, which I love the Hunger Games. I have since the very beginning. I read all the books. I've watched all the movies. And I knew what to expect from Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. But oh my goodness, I went on an emotional roller coaster that entire movie. So if you haven't seen it, I highly recommend. And now we've reached December. Not a whole lot happened on the 1st, 2nd, or 3rd, but on the 4th, that's when Fred the Ladybug decided to join me all in communications class. It was my last in-person communications class. And Fred the Ladybug sat on my name tag the entire time. So it was a great day. And I'm glad Fred joined me. A few hours later, my Relief Society president dropped off crumble cookies for me and Julie. And that was just great. Me and Julie enjoyed those crumble cookies. we savored them and enjoyed them and tried to make them last as long as we possibly could. So we enjoyed that. On the 6th, which was Academic Prep Days, this is a vlog on the channel. That was Battle of the Boulevards, which, for those of you who don't know, Battle of the Boulevards is the game against Belmont and Lipscomb. And it was both of our basketball teams, and I worked both games. So I worked that doubleheader. It was my first doubleheader ever, and it was so much fun. Like, I thoroughly enjoyed working that and experiencing it. Both our women's and men's team ended up winning, so we won the Boulevard in general, and I'm just so thankful we were able to. December 10th is part of my finals vlog, and my shower broke, and that really sent me into a mental breakdown. We love that. Thankfully, the shower should be fixed by the time I get back. But I'm always just a little bit scared now, you know, that something's going to go wrong. That's okay. The 13th, I flew back. So I finished my history final and flew back home, which was great. But while I was in the airport, I got Goo Goo Clusters because my family loves Goo Goo Clusters, okay? We are obsessed with Goo Goo Clusters here in the Christensen household. Every single time I come back to Utah, I have to bring some, whether it be little Goo Goos or the peanut butter Goo Goo Clusters themselves. It has to happen. And so I posted it on my story and tagged Goo Goo Clusters. And they reposted me and said, "We're so glad we're a part of your family tradition." So that made December. Okay, that made December. December was a dumpster fire until that happened. And then on the 21st, I went on a date. We saw a concert at the conference center and then went to Cafe Rio. Now, it was not a, like, one-on-one date. It was a double date. My brother asked a girl out, so they were one of the couples, and then I went with that girl's older brother. We were the other couple. That was their first dates ever in general, so, like, I felt like a double date was the way to go. And it was overall enjoyable. I really enjoyed myself. It was a little scary sometimes while I was driving, because I was not getting necessarily the best directions, and I get anxiety in the car when I'm driving because of a traumatic driving experience, which honestly I should do a story time about. But yeah, and then Christmas happened. Christmas was fabulous. I already told you guys about what I got for Christmas in my what I got for Christmas video and what everyone else got for Christmas, and everyone really had a great Christmas. It was fabulous and thoroughly enjoyable, which is great because there were a lot of ups and downs this year, okay? If we're being honest, there have been a lot of ups and downs, highs and lows, trials and tribulations, and because of that roller coaster of emotions, that's why we're ending the year kind of mid. We're not at a low point. We're not at a high point. We're just kind of in the middle right now. And you know what? That is okay. That is okay. A lot of these things were out of my control. And people have been able to see it on stories and in videos and in conversations. And to the people who have followed along on this journey this year, I thank you so much. You have truly made it better. I have loved reading comments and connecting with you guys on stories and personal experiences that I share, and I can't wait to bring them about even more. I'm excited to bring about Spilling Happiness. I also have a series that will be coming out starting in April for a lot of my friends who are in high school and have been asking me some awesome questions about past leadership experiences that I have. So that's a series that they can look forward to, but it's also a series on this channel that people who do not necessarily know a whole lot about me will be able to get to know me even more. And who knows? Maybe I will post my scary lift story time or my reason why I have anxiety getting behind the driving steering wheel in a car. maybe those will come out next year. But yeah, I'm so thankful. And I hope 2024 is an even better year. Has less lows. Crossing fingers. I hope it has less lows. lows. I hope there's more highs in 2024. I hope there's more blessings in store. But most importantly, I hope you guys have a wonderful year and open yourself to many blessings and opportunities that are coming your way. I thank you so much for following along on my journey and watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, follow, like, you know, do all the things. And I am wishing you a happy new year and a wonderful rest of your day, night, or whatever. Bye, everyone.
Don't ever let a single moment pass you by.